Hi, I'm Peter from URender, and in this video I will show you how to combine volumetrics and our simple fog to get nice atmospheric effects. Here I have a Quixel rock asset and distributed it randomly with a cloner and random effector. Everything else is just default settings for now. First, let's have a look at our simple fog. This is a very simple kind of effect. It uses the depth information of the scene and blends it with a single color. It's like if you would render out a depth pass and use it as luminosity map in compositing. You can set the fog color itself with density and also a simple heat falloff. You also can set a black color and then fade out the scene into the dark. The background strength blends the fog color with the background, and this can be very useful, but more on this later. The simple fog is extremely fast, but there is no interaction with the light sources in the scene. This would be very important to get gorgeous, for example. So deactivate the simple fog for now. Next, I will create a light source, in this case a spotlight, and use a null object for adjusting the position. Now I create a volume object. There are two modes for the object, layered and cube. The layered mode is an infinite area that is filled with the voxels. It is good for global fog and atmospheric effects. The cube mode lets the volumetrics appear inside the cube and is good if you need volumetrics in a limited area. There are several ways you can use the layered mode. First, I will use it as a general atmospheric effect and will set the density for media A and B to the same value to get a more even effect. Depending on your scene scale, you would need to adjust the density of the volume object or globally in the render settings. Currently, our volumetrics get a color from the used light source. Here I change the light color to a warm sunlight, but in some cases you maybe don't want to have the volumetrics be warm tinted. If that is the case, just duplicate your light source and then deactivate the according settings how the light sources influence diffuse, specular and volumetrics. But in this scene, I'm fine with only using one light source. Now I create a camera and will look for a nice perspective and change the focal length too. Next, I create another volume object to create some kind of ground fog. This should not be so evenly appearing, so I activate the noise. To adjust it, I recommend setting the contrast to a maximum first and adjust the scale value depending on your scene scale. Maybe you also want to adjust the media AB blend range and the Y position. Increasing the octaves, lacunarity and persistence creates a more detailed distribution. If you want to have some clouds, you also can use the layered mode. Just set the orientation to negative Y and move it upwards. Note that now the volumetric layer object is distributing voxels infinitely far in positive Y direction. So you have to activate the clip value for media B. Now you prevent getting your cloud layer too thick. Also activate the noise for the clouds and enable volumetric shadows in the light tag. You now may tweak the settings a little bit, like the density, clip values and light intensity. It is also very important to set a U-Render camera with near and far clipping values as close as possible. This will increase the resolution of the used voxels. Let's rotate the light source and see if we can find some nicer values. Now it's time to set the simple fog. First, drag the background strength to 0. Then adjust the settings until you are happy and don't care if the result gets flat. We will adjust it later with the post-processing curves. Then slightly increase the background strength. Next, you can change the ambient occlusion method to ground truth ambient occlusion and adjust the values. Now it's time to bring back some contrast by setting an S-curve into a post-processing filter. You can further increase the entire density of the voxel grid in the render settings. The resolution in Z, that is depending on the camera, should be approximately twice as high as the values for X and Y to get the best result. Note that the higher the settings, the slower the scene will get. I like to increase the resolution X, Y, Z and then use the subdivision slider to change fast between high and low quality. I think some more mountains in the background would be fine, and that is not a problem. Just copy and place them wherever you want. Furthermore, I just want to show you what huge impact it has when adjusting the global density scale of the volumetrics. This is not just blending. Because the volumetrics also casts shadows, the appearance is getting completely different if you set more or less density. If you want to do a quick animation, it could be done really very fast. Just animate the speed and movement of your ground fog and clouds. You also can rotate your light source and then make a slight camera movement with a vibrate tag. I prefer to use linear curves for these kinds of movements. Then just set multiframe sampling and render out your animation into the picture viewer. Well done! Thanks for watching.